Hey there, Mr. Reddit here. Welcome back to another episode of r/EntitledParentStories. Our first story we'll be reading today. The time an entitled mom tried to cover me in sauce. After that, my entitled mom uses her birthday as an excuse to bully my nephew. And after that, crazy lady screamed at a cashier, so I screamed right back. Now for every thumbs up this video gets, one Karen gets covered in sauce. What kind of sauce? So please smash that like button. And if you're new, subscribe and turn on notifications for new stories from Reddit every single day. The time an entitled mom tried to cover me in sauce. So, r/AskReddit has a thread about the tackiest thing you've ever seen at a wedding, and I was reminded of this fun incident from the 3 months I worked catering. Worst of all my food service jobs, by the way. Cast, we've got me. We've got entitled mom, entitled dad, entitled brat, we've got my boss, we've got the bride and the groom. So, campus catering rarely did weddings, and honestly, the food we made was so bad and so poorly handled, I'd think you'd want to avoid it. But the father of the groom was a big name on campus, so it was held on campus, and we had to cater it. I'm managing the entrees, serving up terrible chicken in a thick, congealed sauce, and vegetarian pasta that's basically just a crappy pasta primavera with cheap, nasty oil on it. Seriously, I love me some primavera and wouldn't touch this garbage with a 10-foot pole. We're winding down, the last of the food is out, in a few minutes we will put the main course away and set out the dessert course. Suddenly, entitled Brad appears. He's about 10, so he absolutely knows better than to do this. He decides that it's going to be the funniest thing in the entire world to yank the tablecloth away. Seriously, he was giggling the whole time, so I knew something was up. When I caught him with the edge of the tablecloth, I moved fast. Me, kid, don't even think about it. It's going to end very badly. Entitled Brad giggles more and starts pulling. So I walk over, take the tablecloth out of his hand, and tell him to scram. I go back behind the table, smooth my apron, and continue my awful job. And that's when things went badly. Entitled Mom, why did you chase my baby? He wasn't doing anything wrong. Me, ma'am, your kid was about to pull the tablecloth down, and it's my job to stop him. If I don't, I could be fired. Yes, this happened to be a colleague. We are paying for this wedding. Don't you know who I am? That's when I realized this was the mother of the bride. Me, ma'am, I understand, but there are lit, and that was when she jumped across the table, grabbed my head, and tried to force my face into the tray of sauce for the chicken, a very hot tray heated by a lit sterno underneath. I, of course, started hitting and screaming. The father of the groom came running over. Entitled Dad comes running over. The bride and groom come running. My boss comes running. Entitled Dad suddenly decides to try helping his wife try to shove my face into the sauce. I start clawing at him too, while the groom and his dad try to pry these people off me. The bride screams something like, "You promised! You promised!" I'm not entirely sure here. It was chaos. My boss is standing off to one side like a potato. All the while, entitled Brad is sitting off to the side, laughing like this is the funniest thing he's ever seen. In the end, the table went over and caught on fire from the sternos. A fire extinguisher was employed, and the wedding was basically ruined. My boss pulled me aside while I prepared to file a police report. Boss, you can't talk to the police. Me, actually I can. Boss, if you talk to the police, I'll fire you. Me, that's illegal, you can't do that. Boss, your choice. I filed the police report and told them what my boss said. He didn't fire me. Entitled Mom and Entitled Dad pled guilty. The bride handed me a huge slice of cake because she was pretty sure my boss would steal my tips. He did. Speaking of sauce, what's your favorite sauce of all time? Please let us know.
I'm more of a Szechuan girl myself.
My entitled mom uses her birthday as an excuse to bully my nephew. My mother has always been an entitled little jerk, but plays it off as passive-aggressive for the most part. She talks to everyone like a good Christian grandma and talks to her kids like a Karen from heck. I always just brushed it off when I was younger and soldiered through with a thought of, when I'm 18, I'm moving so far away from you. Now I'm 29 and living 1,000 miles away from her, and life is sweet. The only thing that I regret about living this far away from her is that my three sisters and two nephews are all still down south with her. My oldest and youngest sister both live a few hours away from her, but the second youngest sister recently went through a divorce, and now she and her two boys live with my mom and stepdad. Because my sister works long hours at a small chain retail store, my parents are usually left babysitting my nephews. I have a few stories of my mom being entitled over the years, but this particular one happened just this past Thanksgiving. When I moved north, my mom asked that I make it home for Thanksgiving.
It's my birthday that week too, and it would mean so much to me if you could come down to see me.
Alright, yeah, that's somewhat doable. I didn't have much money after spending it all on the move, but I could scrape together enough to go visit for a few days. I drove down and spent 3 days with the family, with plans to drive back the day after my mom's birthday. The first day, I was expecting my mom to be the one giddy and showering me in affection for coming to visit, but instead, it was my nephews. They're 6 and 3 and were over the moon happy to have someone other than grandparents to play with. My mom didn't even come to say hi to me, just waved over her shoulder at me as she walked into my stepdad's office and closed the door. My stepdad was already in there, and I could tell they were waiting for me to arrive so I could babysit and they could have some quiet time. I get that. I'm 100% okay with spending time with nephews because they are sweet boys and I love them. But what the heck? I'm here to visit you too, and you don't even bother greeting me or looking at me? That whole day was with my nephews and my younger sister. She drove down after me. We spent the whole day playing and watching movies and had a great time. I barely saw my mom the entire time. It wasn't until the boys were going to bed that my mom finally did come out to talk to me. But by this point, she was 3 or 4 drinks in and wearing her nightgown, ready to go to bed. She mumbled something along the lines of being happy to have me home, missed me so much, etc., etc. But by morning, she had no recollection of it and just made excuses for not speaking to me the whole day as she was
just so tired from dealing with work and the boys and church all the time. I needed a break.
Whatever. Day 2, she did talk to me. She barked at me to take my nephews outside while she shampooed the rugs and carpets of every room in the house. So I complied, and my nephews and I played outside for a long time. It wasn't hot, but the sun was out and bright. We were out there for a few hours, running around and goofing off. Eventually, the boys got hungry, and I was exhausted from chasing them around. So I opened the door to see if it was okay to come back in, and my mom immediately started barking at us to stay outside until the floors were clean. Okay, well, the boys and I are hungry and I'm tired, so if we can't come in, then at least let me get my keys. I'll take them to get lunch in town. My mom immediately changed her tune. She didn't want us to leave the house without her on her birthday. It's her day. She wants to spend it with her babies, etc. So she said we could come in, but to stay out of their bedroom and playroom as those were fully carpeted and still wet. The boys, being 6 and 3, weren't listening and charged into the playroom to grab some toys to have a picnic with outside. My mom started fuming at me for it. The boys realized they got me in trouble and the 6-year-old apologized while the 3-year-old shrugged it off. I told them it was okay and we went and had our picnic on the front porch in the shade with their toys. Later that evening, my mom starts announcing that we need to get dressed and ready to go out but hasn't told us where we're going. I asked her and she replied absolutely giddy,
"It's my birthday! We're going out to eat! I've been wanting to go to this Chinese buffet in town for ages!"
I personally didn't care. I had been dieting for months leading up to my visit, and my mom's cooking, heavily saturated in grease and butter, had me feeling nauseous, so I wasn't planning on eating much of anything. I start to help the boys get ready, and the 6-year-old starts whining that he wants pizza, not Chinese. My mom starts snapping at him that it's
my birthday, not yours! You want pizza? Eat it on your birthday.
This has my nephew angry and not wanting to get ready, which his little brother now doesn't see the point in wearing shoes and a jacket if big brother isn't. I talk to the 6-year-old and tell him that there may be pizza there. Most Chinese buffets down south have pizza for the kids, and start listing all the other yummy foods they have, and he agrees to get ready but isn't happy about it. I get them dressed, we all load into the car, and as we're driving there, the nephew starts asking me about the pizza again. My mom again snaps at him, this time telling him to stop fussing or whining.
"You're ruining my birthday! If you want pizza, then we'll eat it on your birthday. But today is my day, and we're doing what I want."
Nephew says his birthday is months away. He's taking my mom's argument to think that he can't eat pizza for months. This makes him start to sob. My mom then snaps at me that it's my fault for getting his hopes up and that she has heard me lie to him about there being pizza at the restaurant. I then snap back at her that I said the word maybe and called her out for acting like a spoiled kid and talking down to a 6-year-old when she's nearly 10 times his age and refuses to act like it on her day. My mom got huffy and finally snapped. My stepdad tried to throw in his 2 cents by saying we all need to calm down and that no one is right. That just got my mom mumbling to him about how her day is being ruined. I held my nephew's hand and whispered to both of them that if they didn't like the food at the restaurant, then we could stay up late and I'd make us a pizza to share when their mom came home from work. That got the older one to cheer up a little. But when we arrived at the restaurant, the older nephew didn't want to get out of the car. He was fighting tears, saying he was scared of my mom and that he didn't want to have her yell at him again. Knowing my mom would never let her Karen attitude slip in public, I told him that I would sit with him and his brother so he didn't have to sit by her. He agreed to come in after that. Each time the boys went to get food, I was the one to go with them. I was fine with this because, again, I was too nauseous to eat. My mom noticed I didn't have a plate of my own and asked why I wasn't eating. I told her I wasn't feeling well and didn't want to eat to risk further upset. She didn't respond. I took the younger nephew to the restroom after that, and when we came back, the older nephew was coming back from the buffet with an empty plate. I asked him if he wanted more food, and he just shook his head and fought back tears again. I asked if he was okay, and he told me that while I took his brother to the bathroom, my mom told him that it was his fault that I wasn't eating, that he and his brother were being such little piggies that I was too disgusted to eat. So he was getting another plate so that he could get me some food, and he wasn't going to eat any more of his. I was even more upset with my mom at this point. Told my nephew that I was okay and that I was going to talk to my mom about this. We went back to the table together, and I told her to her face, just loud enough for a few others to hear, that it was her cooking that made me sick, that she coats everything in butter and cheese when I'm lactose intolerant and she knows that, that I've been dieting to lose weight because I'm morbidly obese, and that after months of clean and healthy eating, one day with her food has me ready to vomit. But none of that is my nephew's fault, and there is no excuse on the planet for shaming a 6-year-old for eating. She turned her nose up at me and said she didn't know what I was talking about. Then she pretended that others didn't hear what I said when it was obvious that they did. I promised my nephew I'd get a plate of things with him and would only eat if he ate it with me. Me, him, and his brother all went to the dessert aisle and loaded that thing down with cakes and pudding. I snuck a few pieces of sushi to the side and ate those while the boys loaded up on the sweets. So my mom decided to make herself feel better by taking me to her favorite store and showing me around. We looked at a bunch of different things, and the boys were starting to get sluggish and tired. They had played all day without a nap, and their sugar rush from the dessert bar was causing them to crash fast. I rushed our trip through so we could get them home, but my mom kept nagging that she wanted to stop at other stores while they were still open. This caused her to eventually complain that the boys were clinging to me too much. I reluctantly agreed to go to Walmart after this. The plan was for my stepdad to stay in the car while the boys slept, but my stepdad changed his mind and wanted to check out the gardening section. And since I had to shop with my mom, then the boys did too. They crawled into the cart, and my mom and stepdad started to walk off with them. I went to the restroom, and then when I left, I couldn't find them, and my phone had died, so I couldn't call them. So I wound up waiting at the car for at least 30 minutes. When they came back, my parents seemed annoyed and the boys were quiet, still looking sleepy. I loaded them into the car, and just a few minutes down the road, the older one started making a noise. I was sitting driver's side back seat. He was passenger side back seat. His little brother was between us. It was dark, so I couldn't quite see his face, but eventually, I heard him sniffle as we passed under a street lamp and I could see tears on his cheeks. I reached over to wipe one away and asked him what was wrong. He told me he was sad that I was leaving in the morning and that he didn't want me to go. He started begging for me to call my job and ask if I could stay for a few more days. This broke my heart. I couldn't even think of words to say. I felt tears in my eyes too. Before I could say or do anything, his little brother reached forward and wrapped his arms around mine and laid his head on me and softly said, "Please stay." Tears fell so hard at that point. I missed these boys so much, and the time spent with them was the best I had had in months. I didn't want to leave, but knew that I couldn't stay.
Before I was able to respond, my mom starts in again, this time saying, "Stop your crying! Don't waste what little time she has left being upset. You're ruining it for everyone." My nephew cringed and tried to pull his hands away from mine. I just gripped his hands tighter and bit my tongue. I was so ready to scream at my mother, but didn't want to do that in front of the boys, especially since all she had done was tear them down and make them feel bad because of me. If I showed that I was angry and started to argue with my mom, then they'd think it was their fault too. I told my nephew that I want to stay, but explained that I have friends and responsibilities that I have to get back to, but promised to come back and visit as soon as I can and to call more often so we can play and talk more. The older nephew leaned on his brother, who continued to lean on me, and we remained like that the whole ride home. They fell asleep on my arm, and my arm fell asleep under them, but it was worth it. I didn't even speak to my mom for the remainder of my stay. She didn't seem bothered by it. I told my sister what all had happened while we were out to dinner and how disappointed I was that our mom had been acting like this to her precious grandbabies. My sister told me that our mom has actually done worse, that she doesn't have proof of it or she would have done something by now, but she believes our mom has been drinking when she's supposed to be watching the boys. They don't have bruises or marks from her, but my sister has seen a few red whelps that they won't tell her where they came from, but they look suspiciously like our stepdad's hand. I begged my sister to get the boys and get out, even offered to help them move up north with me. She said she didn't want to go that far north because she doesn't want to take the boys too far away from their father and his family, just because of our parents being jerks. She did tell me that our older sister was making arrangements for them to move in with her in the coming months. The sooner the better. It's now the end of June 2020, and my younger sister and her boys are finally moving in with our older sister. It's been hard for me to get in contact with my younger sister because of our insane work schedules and everything going on right now, but I've been keeping good to my word and chatting with my nephews often. They've gotten so spoiled with chatting with me on the phone that while I was typing this, they've called me 5 times. So, thank you for reading this far. Have a great day. I have to go entertain kiddos now. Have you ever had a family member act like this towards you? And if so, what did you do about it? We would love to hear from you.
But it was her birthday! She did nothing wrong.
Crazy lady screamed at a cashier, so I screamed right back. I had just resigned from my extremely stressful retail job to pursue a career in real estate. I had been sworn at, threatened, and generally treated like crap because customer service. I had to go back to a store that was a different branch to the one I worked at, but still the same company. Some background information. In our country, electricity is prepaid, and in certain cases, a free voucher is issued in the first few days of the month along with your prepaid voucher if you are elderly or received government assistance. This is wholly issued by the government, and the cashiers have zero control over whether or not your free ticket will be issued. So I'm standing in line behind an elderly lady, and she asks the cashier for an electricity voucher. Cashier rings up the voucher, takes the cash, and gives the elderly lady her voucher. Elderly lady looks at the voucher and says,
"This isn't right. Where the heck is my free voucher?"
So by now, I'm steaming. I hate when cashiers are treated like dirt. Cashier explains to the lady that she doesn't control the electricity vouchers and advises the elderly lady to contact her local electricity department. This is 100% the correct answer, as per the company protocol. Old lady now screams at the cashier. Manager comes along and explains the same thing. They didn't control the vouchers and she needs to contact the electricity department. There's literally nothing else they can do. Cashier is in tears by now, and this lady is calling her all kinds of names. The poor kid is shaking. And then I realize that I no longer work there, so I don't need to appease this screaming banshee, and I do something I have never, ever done before. I said, "The cashier has explained this to you. The manager has explained this to you. Now I'm going to explain it to you. These people can't help you. You're a sad, miserable jerk who doesn't... You're a sad, miserable jerk who doesn't deserve the courtesy this nice girl has given you. Buzz off." The old lady literally couldn't believe someone else called her out on her bad behavior and left. She mumbled something about how she better not see me outside, and I laughed. I said she's welcome to do whatever she wants, but so am I. I'm not proud of how I spoke to this old lady, but no way will I stand by and watch someone being unjustly treated. By the time I finished my transaction, both the manager and cashier were smiling. I know they probably were very glad that someone could voice exactly what they were thinking.
Have any of you ever called out a customer on their behavior? If so, how did they take it? Please let us know.
I dare you to call me out on my behavior.
No, you don't work here, lady. I've never been mistaken for an employee at a place I don't work at, but I did have to tell a Karen that she doesn't work at my store. I work at a 7-Eleven, and I've been there for about 6 years now. I used to work night shift. Boy, do I have some stories from those days. But one that really stands out for this subreddit is the time I had to tell a lady she doesn't work at my store. It was late one night, or perhaps early in the morning, and my cover had gone home for the night, so I was running the store by myself. I had an older woman come in with a younger woman, late 40s and early 20s, so I'm assuming mother and daughter. Mom just so happens to have that Karen vibe to her. She walks up to my counter while I'm taking care of some tasks. Karen,
can I use your bathroom?
Now, we don't have a public bathroom at my store. We have a staff bathroom, but it's behind a locked door that needs a code to get in. Naturally, we aren't supposed to let customers use it. Me, sorry, we don't have a bathroom. Karen,
well, where do you guys go to the bathroom then?
Me, we have a staff bathroom, but it's for staff only.
Well, I'm staff, so you have to let me use your bathroom.
Me, I don't think you work here.
Yes, I do. I worked for 7-Eleven 20 years ago, so you have to let me use your bathroom.
Again, it's a bathroom for staff only. We'll make an exception for employees that left recently, but even if this lady is telling the truth, she left the company before I was even born. Me, I'm sorry, I can't let you use our bathroom.
Well, I want to speak to your manager.
It's about 3 in the morning right now, so our manager is asleep. I'm kinda losing my mind here, because this is my first interaction with a Karen in the wild. I'm still relatively new to the company too, so I can't think of any other option right now. Me, okay, I'll give her a call. I call my manager, and she's very not pleased. I explain the situation, and she tells me the best thing to do is ask her to leave. I head back out from the back, making sure to close the door behind me. No promised land for her. When I get back to the counter, she has that impatient Karen trademark look about her. Me, I called my manager, and she says you can't use our bathroom. Karen,
yeah, right.
Passive-aggressive eye roll. Me, my manager also said you have to leave.
Whatever. If I pee myself, it's all your fault.
Thankfully, she didn't rage a huge stink about it, but wow. I can't think of another time I've had to tell a customer that they don't work at my store. Usually if they do, they know the code already and can just walk into the back to talk to the boss. So that's my horror story from the days of endless night shift. I hope you enjoyed reading it a lot more than I enjoyed living it. Speaking of 7-Eleven, do you have a favorite convenience store to shop at? Please let us know.
Bucky's for the win.
An eventful end to my shift. This guy came in to return a lawnmower, except that he's clearly drunk. So drunk that he could barely walk. Me and a coworker went out to his car to help him unload it, and when he opened his trunk, an empty beer bottle fell out. The man had a bag full of them, so I'm surprised only one fell out. I went to help him move the lawnmower to a cart and caught a whiff of the alcohol in his breath. He reeked of it. My mask didn't protect me from it, unfortunately. After helping him, I told my team lead, then went and told the manager who was in charge at the time, and then I punched out because my shift was over. I stuck around though, because I wanted to see what happened. Manager showed up and took over the guy's return. There were some issues. The computer said the mower had already been returned, and dude started getting agitated. I turned around for a second, and he up and disappeared while manager was trying to figure it out. As this was happening, some customers came to the service desk and told us that another guy, on the other side of the store, seemed lost, bewildered, and it appeared that he had went to the bathroom on himself. Now, I would have paid more attention to the second guy initially if not for the first guy reappearing, going to town on a leaf blower box trying to open it, wanting to test it out, I guess. He couldn't return the mower and instead bought a leaf blower and some wood. At one point, he was laying down on top of the wood on top of a cart. Manager headed over to deal with guy number two. As he's heading to the other side of the store, I asked manager if he called the cops on drunk guy. He said he hadn't, as he wanted to see what the guy would do first. So I told him at some point, this guy was going to get back behind the wheel, something I wasn't comfortable with whatsoever, and he had left his dog in his car. Did I mention he left his dog in the car? That convinced my manager to call the police. As he headed over to see what was going on with the second guy, I headed back to see if drunk guy had left yet. He hadn't, and the cops showed up while he's still figuring out how to keep the wood on top of his truck. Cops talked to him for a bit, headed off to the other side of the store. Turned out, manager called the cops on both the drunk guy and bewildered guy. I went to tell the manager that the cops had arrived, and I asked him what was the deal with the second guy. Bewildered guy said he wanted to use the bathroom, but it was locked. It wasn't. He then refused to leave and straight up fell asleep slash passed out in a chair. More cops showed up, an ambulance was called, and bewildered guy was taken to the hospital. The cops told drunk guy the second he decided to get in his car and drive, they'd arrest him. So what did he decide to do? Headed back into the store, returned the wood he had just bought, and bought something else instead. The parking lot had like 7 cop cars in it by this point, so drunk guy was clearly spooked. So he grabbed his dog and wandered off. At that point, I'd seen all I needed to see, so I went home 90 minutes after my shift ended. What's the craziest thing that's ever happened at your job? Please let us know. Mess with the marching band? March yourself home. I went to a very large secondary school, middle plus high school in the United States, with a population of over 4,000 students. Because of the school's size and excellent funding, the marching band had its own percussion equipment, wheeled carts, and golf carts to pull them, which were stored in cargo containers in the back parking lot by some classroom trailers. I was on the equipment crew for the marching band, and by the time my senior year rolled around, the containers were about 30 years old and one had started leaking. The band director, let's call him Mr. Connex, finally was able to get them replaced after begging the administration for several years. The new ones would be arriving on a Friday, and a different company would be hauling away the old ones on Wednesday of the next week. So for a few days, the old containers were going to be taking up a section of the parking lot. This wasn't a problem, because the night before, after rehearsal, Mr. Connex had us measure out an extensively large section of the back parking lot and cone it off, so the crew would have plenty of room to work the next day. We filled up the band hall with all the equipment and had the containers empty so the crew could move them, put the new ones in their place with minimal effort the next day. This is the part I only heard about, because I was in class when it happened. The assistant band director was running the band classes for the first part of the day, and Mr. Connex was outside making sure everything would be just so, when all of a sudden, a lady drives up, narrowly threads the gap between two cones, and parks right in the middle of where the old containers are going to be stored until next week. Let's call her Mrs. Seekin. Mrs. Seekin had an important meeting with her daughter's guidance counselor. Mr. Connex walks over and politely informs her that she will need to park somewhere else because the forklift crew would be arriving soon, and in return, she went off on him, complaining that because they had coned off so much of the back parking lot, the nearest parking was off campus, and she'd need to walk about a quarter mile to get to the main building from there. Mr. Connex told her one more time that she was parked in the middle of the space that the workmen needed, and she told him, in no uncertain terms, to buzz off, before heading around towards the front of the building. At this point, Mr. Connex called the principal, Dr. Intermodal, and informed him of the situation. Unfortunately, with the number of buildings on campus and how many guidance counselors there are in a school with over 4,000 students, it would take the better part of an hour to actually figure out where on the campus she had gone and which guidance counselor she was meeting. Our school had over 20. The school resource officer could probably write them a ticket, but that was about all he could do. Calling a tow truck would probably be faster, but even then, it would take about 30 minutes at least to get the car out of the way, and the work crew would be arriving in 10, and any delay would be an unexpected expense for the school. Then Mr. Connex had an idea. He ran it by Dr. Intermodal, and the principal ratified it, so he set his plan into motion. When the work crew arrived, several semi-trucks, carrying the newer containers and a forklift, Mr. Connex gave them very specific instructions for how to arrange the old containers when they moved them out of the way for the other company to pick up. A perfect box around Mrs. Seekin's car, with barely enough room for a person to step through between the corners. Her SUV was going to spend hard time in car jail until Wednesday. Then the new containers were unloaded where the old ones had been and the work crew left. About an hour later was my band class period, and since being in marching band was a requirement for the symphonic band, everyone in the room was part of the band, so everyone got conscripted to move the equipment back out into the new containers. Some of us noticed the car in the middle of the old containers, but nobody had a chance to ask the director about it, until about halfway through the process when Mrs. Seekin returned and shouted these legendary words, which I shall never forget until the day I die. "What the heck?"
Where is my car?
I can only imagine the sheer terror she felt upon rounding the corner and finding the place where she had parked her car replaced with a giant steel box. To this, Mr. Connex simply, calmly responded, "Exactly where I told you not to park it." At this point, literally everyone had stopped working, and the few of us who had noticed the trapped car surmised what had happened and were basically dying of laughter. Mrs. Seekin ran over to the containers and looked through the gap and screamed when she saw there was literally no way for her to get the car out.
"You should fix this right now! You should fix this right now!" she demanded, storming towards Mr. Connex.
He simply shrugged and told her that the containers were getting towed away on Wednesday next week. She could easily retrieve her car then. This only seemed to make her more mad, and at this point, me and some of the other larger dudes moved between her and the band director because she looked about ready to bite his head off. At this point, the director essentially delivered the ultimatum that if she had no further business on school grounds, she should leave or he'd call the SRO, School Resource Officer, a police officer stationed at the school. Her response was something along the lines of,
"Call him! Call him! Show him what you did to my car! That's a crime!"
I don't know what crime she thought the band director committed, but long story short, the SRO arrived, laughed his butt off, then instructed her to leave school grounds and come back for her car on Wednesday. She screamed at him a bit about how she couldn't walk 4 miles home. Oh, poor you. And the SRO, after a few minutes, was done with her crap and told her if she didn't leave school grounds immediately, she'd be cited for trespassing, at which point she left. The cherry on top. Over the weekend, someone stole the wheels off the car. So even after the containers were moved, she couldn't get her car until one of those portable service companies came and put new wheels on it at some point Friday afternoon.
Huge shout out to Royalty 2018, who just left us a review on iTunes. It took me forever to find this, and I'm super happy. This is the best thing to fall asleep to. Thanks, Mr. Reddit. Hearts.
Thanks, Royalty. We hope you continue to enjoy the Mr. Reddit podcast, available on Spotify and iTunes.
Join as a channel member today, or leave us a review on iTunes, and we'll give you a special shout out in our next video. And if you'd like us to make a special video for you or a loved one, come visit us on Fiverr. Link pinned in the comments below.